Welcome to this video on creating an ASP.NET MVC application with an embedded dashboard viewer. If you want to embed the dashboard file created using Dashboard Designer into your ASP.NET MVC application, you can check this video explained with the manual steps. Consider I have a dashboard file saved into the local file path called Telecom Dashboard Telecommunications file, and I'm going to visualize this dashboard file from the ASP.NET MVC application. This is an actual output in the web browser when we launch from the MVC project. Let's see how to achieve this result by step-by-step process. Ensure that you have installed Dashboard Platform SDK in your development machine. For the installation steps, please refer the video and documentation links in this video description. Confirm the folders named Fonts, Scripts and Themes exist inside the HTML folder from the local app data location, and Syncfusion dashboard service is hosted and running. For this demo sample, Syncfusion dashboard service is hosted in IIS Express. To host the dashboard service in web service like IIS, IIS Express, please refer the documentation and video links in this video description. Let us create a new empty ASP.NET MVC project using Microsoft Visual Studio Development Environment. We need to add the scripts, themes, and fonts from the HTML folder to our application. So here I'm going to create a folder called content and paste those static files. Now we have to add the dashboard viewer ASP.NET MVC wrapper assemblies into the references from the precompiled assemblies folder. You can find the precompiled assemblies folder from the local app data location and use your compatible version of .NET framework. Let's add the assembly syncfusion.ej.dashboardviewer.mvc library into the project. Now create a controller class with any name, and I'm going to name it as Dashboard Viewer Controller. In the project's web.config file, add the assembly and namespace information under the system.web section. In the web.config file, which is under the views folder, add namespace information under the system.web.webpages.racer section. Now we have completed to setting up the project. Let's see how to add the dashboard viewer control. I'm going to create a racer view called index.cshtml. Refer the needed themes and JavaScript files which was already added to the application from the HTML folder. To initialize the dashboard viewer control, we need to add the code under the body section of index.cshtml page. The code contains the controls name, service URL, and dashboard path. Dashboard file path should be passed to the API. The path should be accessible to the dashboard service URL. In order to get the path generically, I'm attaching the dashboard file to the project. Now set the build action property to content and copy to output directory to copy always, so that wherever this application is hosted, the path will be generic. Dashboard path can be in the local machine or from the online, which is required to be downloadable from the given dashboard service. We have other API support also and can be initialized along with the dashboard viewer control, as like we did for service URL and dashboard path. Now build and run the application to view the dashboard. Now, the dashboard file is visualized by adding the Syncfusion Dashboard Viewer control using Dashboard Viewer ASP.NET MVC wrapper. Thanks for watching the video.